Good morning, students of class 9. Welcome back to the online classes now. We are doing history, the French Revolution, and we are doing 1.0, French society during the late 18th century. The society, how they live, what they do, so we'll talk about that. How was the society constituted? Now, here, number one, there are altogether 7 points. Number one, French society was divided into three states. Three states means three groups. Three states, three groups. First class, second class, third class. In the 18th century. During 18th century, the French society was divided into three groups. You can say three states. Only the member of the third state, paid the taxes. Remaining first class, second class, first state, second state, they do not have to pay the taxes. Only the third states had to pay, they had to pay the tax. And the member of the third class or third states were usually very poor peasants. The whole burden of the country rest towards these peasants. These peasants, they had to pay the tax, and the country was run by the ministers and the king. The society of states was part of the feudal system. Feudal system means the king used to give some powers to the ministers, and minister used to collect the taxes. They used to maintain the army and all. So in this way, the taxes were collected by the ministers, and they used to manage the certain areas, different areas. So each area has got one minister, and they used to manage. That is called a feudal system. So now, the society of states was part of the feudal system. And number three, peasants. Peasant means third states, very poor people. Peasants, the third state, made up of about 90% of the population. French population, 90% of the population were peasants, and they belonged to third state. You can see only a small number owned the land. In the third state, practically all the people of the third states were poor. Only very few people, they owned land. Rest, they were landless. They had to work in others' field. Especially the field of the landlords, they had to work. Landless laborers they were. So only a small handful of third estate people or peasants owned the land. Own means they have. About 60% of the land, the whole France, the land of France, 60% of the land was owned by nobles. Nobles means ministers, landlords. Nobles, ministers, church. The church also, the clergy. Church. In the church there are priests, and the priest also owned big pieces of land. Church and other rich member of the third state. In the third state, a handful of third state peasants, they owned land. They were quite rich, and these people, they owned the land. Nobilities, yani ministers, church, yani clergy means priest, and the rich member of the third state. They own 60% of the land. That means each minister has got a very big pieces of land, and these peasants used to work there. Land, labor, workers, farm workers. The member of the first and second state, the member of the first class and the second class were the clergy. Clergy means priest. Nobility, ministers, enjoyed certain privileges. Privileges means benefit. What was the benefit? They do not have to pay the tax. First class, second class, first state, second state. You can say either say class or state. First class, second class, they do not have to pay the tax. That was the privileges, benefit. They had big pieces of land, and they do not have to pay the tax. And the landless laborers, peasants, comprising of 90% of the population, they had to pay the tax. You see that? That was an unjust. It was an injustice done towards peasants. Clergy, nobility enjoy certain privileges, means benefit, by birth. By birth, if they are born in the family of nobles, they do not have to pay the tax. If a person is born in the peasant's family, third class, he has to pay the tax. That means by birth. First and second states, first class, second class. You can say that first state and second states were exempted. Exempted means excused. Exempted from paying taxes. You see that? First class, second class, they were not allowed to pay. They do not have to pay the tax. They were exempted. Exempted means not, do not have to. They don't have to pay the tax. Exempted from paying the taxes. So member of the third states, a member of the third class only paid the taxes. You see, that was an injustice done towards them. Peasants were obliged. Obliged means they have to. Peasants were obliged to render. Render means provide services to the lord, landlords. The peasants have to work for the nobilities. Peasants have to work for the clergies. Peasants have to work for the rich farmers, landlords. Work in their house or work in the field or build roads. Road is spelling R-O-A-D-S. They have to build roads and serve in the army. You see, first class and second class, they do not have to do the work. Building roads, working in the field, construction work, or serve in the army, they do not have to do. Only the member of the third class have to do all these things. You see, they have to pay the tax as well as they have to work so hard. So this is something very unjust done towards them. Injustice done towards them. So now this is the French society during the late 18th century. Because of this injustice, later on they started revolution. This is the cause. What are the causes for the rise of French Revolution? These are the causes. Injustice done to them. Only they have to pay the tax. What about the first class, second class? They own big plots of land, they are rich, they have to pay the taxes. But they were exempted from paying the taxes. Only the third estate have to pay the tax, and they were very poor. They do not have their land, they own land. Very few of them, they own the land. You see that. Now more are there. We'll continue our lesson in our next class. Till then, you study properly at home, go through the book, you read also, do the reading is have to be done. Some of you are very poor in reading, I know. So you do the reading and go through the online. You will understand and you read. It becomes more clear. Don't just read question answer only. You have to read thoroughly, mind it. Class 9 students, you have to go through the book properly. You have to understand the lesson. Then only you would be able to answer it. Otherwise, it will become very difficult. From the beginning, I am telling you. So you must go through the book properly, try to understand the lesson. In each part there is something different. So you have to understand what is happening here in this part. So that's all for today. I've told you the method, how to study. It's not like that in other classes you have done that, you have memorized all the question answer and you can write it. No, not like that. It's quite different now. You have entered the different stage. So that's all for today. Now we'll meet in the next class and continue our lessons. Thank you for watching.